Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be installing Python on Windows 11. So let's get right into it. The first thing we're going to do is head to your preferred search engine and search Download Python Windows 11. From here, you should see a link that states Download Python on python.org. So let's just click that. Here you can see we land on a page of downloads with all the versions of Python. At the top of this webpage, we are actually suggested the latest version of Python for our operating system, which, as of today, is Python 3.10.5. So, let's just click on that button and our download will begin. Opening this download executable, we will be prompted by the installer to begin our Python download. Do not worry about custom installation right now, as we just want to ensure all the elements of Python are downloaded correctly for you. But in the future, this is something you can play with future versions of Python. Let's hit Install now, and if any pop-ups from the Python installer appear, just hit Accept and wait for the download to complete. And there we go. We have successfully installed Python 3.10 on Windows 11. So, now that we have installed Python, let's quickly make our first Python program that prints Hello User when the script is run. To do this, let's open up the Python IDE, which was installed with our Python. IDLE stands for Integrated Design and Learning Environment, and is one of the many ways we can code and troubleshoot our Python codes. So, to do this, let's head down to our search bar and enter Python IDLE. You should see Python IDLE for the version of Python you just downloaded. So, for me, that is Python 3.10. So, let's just open that up by double-clicking it. To print a statement to the console, we use the following syntax. We tell Python we want to use the print function, so print brackets, and within those brackets, we give what is called a string in quotation marks, so hello user. Then we run the program by hitting enter. As you can see, we didn't receive any errors and our statement was correctly printed. There you go, you just downloaded Python for Windows 11 and successfully ran your first Python program. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to install Python for Windows 11. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.